comfort the feeble-minded. Support the weak. Be patient toward all men. Be patient. So warn the unruly. Comfort. Support the weak. Be patient. We've heard love. We've heard peace. Amen. We've heard comfort. So this is what we are to do among each other's brothers and sisters. See that none render evil for evil unto any man. No one render evil to evil. No one render evil to evil. And warn anyone that is unruly again. But ever follow that which is good. Follow which is what is good. Both among yourselves and to all men. Follow what is good among ourselves and to all men. Let's keep each other together, brothers and sisters. Let's keep each other together. And let's love each other, brothers and sisters. Verse 16, rejoice evermore. Verse 17, pray without ceasing. Verse 18, in everything give thanks, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning you. Number 19, verse 19, quench not the spirit. Number 20, despise not prophesyings. Verse 21, prove all things, hold fast that which is good. Verse 22, abstain from all appearance of evil. Amen, amen. We are to rejoice. We are to be in rejoicing. We are to be in rejoicing that we know that salvation is here right now. Salvation is here right now. And eternal life, we have the promise of eternal life. And we are to pray. Pray without ceasing. Continue to pray. We need the Father in our lives at all times. Heavenly Father sees everything. The Heavenly Father is here for us all. Amen, amen. In everything, we give thanks. We give thanks. For this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning you, concerning all of us. Quench not the spirit. Quench not the spirit. Stay in good spirit. Stay in good. Don't be bogged down. Don't be drowned down with anything that you should not have in your life. And that's where we are, brothers and sisters, loving each other, comforting each other, uplifting each other at all times, and staying close to God, praying in prayer, staying close to God and doing his will. Okay. And verse 23, and the very God of peace sanctify you wholly, and I pray, God, your whole spirit and soul and body be preserved blameless unto the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. So keep your spirits up, that your soul, your body, everything be preserved blameless unto the coming of the Lord Jesus Christ. Faithful is he that calleth you, who also will do it. Our Lord is faithful. He is faithful, and what he says he will do, he will do. Brethren, pray for us. Brethren, pray for us. We all pray for each other. Pray for each other. Never putting anyone down, praying and uplifting always. All the brethren with as holy, with an holy kiss. Greet everyone with a holy, holy kiss. I charge you by the Lord that this epistle be read unto all the holy brethren. Hallelujah. Amen. And that's what we are doing now. We are reading the words of the Lord, the words of the Lord. And we know right here, this is written by Paul. The last verse, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you. Amen. This is wonderful, wonderful, wonderful. And again, we have heard the words comfort each other. comfort each other and admonish each other, esteem each other highly in love, warn the unruly. Just have that love for everyone. No evil for evil. Just do what is good. Rejoice evermore. Continue to pray always. Always. You must have that personal relationship with the Heavenly Father. The Heavenly Father. Always. Number one. Always. Always. Father, Jesus Christ, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. All three in one. Amen. 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 So this is we are supposed to just have that peace. Have that love. And again, it starts off in there's a scripture in the Bible that talks about when you see this happening, and so forth, and the things happening, changing other seasons, know that the time is near. And again, just like that birth, we don't know exactly, but we know that there's basically 9 months to that baby, and in that month, and supposed to be, they can give you the date. You're gonna supposed to have birth. I don't know. January the first. But sometimes that baby may not come on the first. That baby may come on the 31st. That baby may come on the 2nd, 3rd, or 5th. But we know that it's close, and we don't know the exact time, but we know that it's close. So when things start to happen, and right here, this just says, when they say there's peace, there is perfect peace. There is no country against country. When everything, when they say that the world is at peace, then get ready. Get ready. We know that the president is going over here, going over there, and things are happening and so forth, and we hear from time to time, oh, we're at peace with this country, or we're at peace, or we're trying to go over here and make peace and so forth. When you hear that, it's total peace. Everything's good. We've made everything wonderful and good among each other, United States, all the countries. Then just look out. Keep your eyes open on the things that are happening in the world, the things that are happening in the world, and stay prayed up. And we know that there is only one way to salvation, one way to the kingdom, one way, and that is through Jesus Christ. That is acknowledging that Jesus Christ is your Lord and Savior, knowing that Jesus Christ is the Son of the Heavenly Father, asking Jesus Christ to come into your life, that you accept him as your Lord and Savior. Go in prayer. Go in prayer and ask Jesus to come into your life, and that you know that he died for your sins, that you are saved, that you are on the book of life. Amen, amen. And this is what I want to get out this week, and I pray that I'm coming to you loud and clear, and I pray that you spread the message and that you exhibit, all of us, more love, more peace, more comfort among each other. So spread the word, share the message, do the message. We know that our God is an action God. And tune in every week on Spreaker to the Tuesday replays. And from time to time, I may come in through the week just for a little special message, or maybe just a little passage here, a little one scripture or something like that every now and then. So if you are signed up with me, if you are following me on any one of the Blog Talk or if you're signed up on Spreaker or Blog Talk, then you will get the message via your email address. So just tune in. And I think in order to get the messages that you would have to, I believe, sign up for a show. So I encourage you, if you like to sign up for a show, go ahead. It's self-explanatory. And everything, if you have any questions or comments or questions or anything about it, you can always ask me. Feel free. And if I don't know, I will try to get the answers for you. So go ahead and you can get those messages in your email, your inbox, email inbox, whenever I may do, just come on in between the week. So I want to just thank you for tuning in, and we are going to end in prayer. Tune in every single Thursday. I love you. I love you. I love you, my brothers and my sisters. We are going to end now in prayer. Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, I come to you, Father, today. I thank you, Father, for your message. I thank you, Father, that you sent your Son, Jesus Christ, for us, that we know, Father God, that there is only one way to the kingdom. There is only one way to salvation, and that is through our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. We thank you for sending your Son. We thank you, Jesus Christ, for your sacrifices. We thank you, Heavenly Father, for your love. We thank you for your undeniable love. We thank you for your grace. We thank you for your glory. Heavenly Father, you are our everything, that we cannot do anything on this earth, Father God. We cannot put one foot in front of the other without you. We thank you for leading our footsteps, Father God, and trusting you with all our heart, the scripture says, and we cannot lean on our own understanding. In everything we do, acknowledge you, and you shall lead our paths. You shall direct us, Father. And we stand by that, Father God, and we thank you. We thank you, Father God. I thank you for this day, Heavenly Father. I love you. I love you. In the name of Jesus, through Jesus Christ, I pray. Amen. Amen.